Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Let us start with our today's question. Our today's question is related to some of the teratogenic medications during pregnancy. The clinic nurse is collecting data on a pregnant client in the first trimester. Which finding is most concerning and warrants priority intervention? Which means, out of the four options, which option indicates or which finding made the nurse to make an immediate or a priority intervention? So here we are looking for something bad statement or some of the serious problem. We'll see the options. Option 1 says the client has not been taking prenatal vitamins. Option 2, client is taking lisinopril to control hypertension. Option 3, client reports a whitish vaginal discharge. Option 4, client reports mild cramping pain in the lower abdomen. So what do you think, which will be the right answer? So here the answer is option 2. You know why? Because the lisinopril is a teratogenic medication during pregnancy. I said that we are discussing a topic, a question related to teratogenic medication. What all are the teratogenic medications, or what do you mean by teratogenic medication? The medication that will produce some abnormalities or that will create some problem during pregnancy, that one should not be taken during pregnancy, or these medications are contraindicated during the pregnancy. So what all are those medications? The medications like ACE inhibitors, like angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, for example ranitidine, enalapril and lisinopril. Then another one, angiotensin 2 receptor blockers, example valsartan, then telmisartan, then losartan. So these are some of the medications or group of medications that is contraindicated during pregnancy. So before becoming pregnant or during the first trimester of pregnant, if the nurse, she found that the client is taking such kind of medication, she should immediately inform to the healthcare provider, and the healthcare provider should discontinue this medication and should be replaced with some other medications for treating the non-cases or hypertension or any other problems. So that's why our option 2 is the correct answer. Because these medications, this will lead to fetal abnormalities, renal or cardiac fetal abnormalities, and contraindicated. So that is the option. When we will see why other options, or what is the point related to other options, wrong options. First option, that is prenatal vitamins. The client is not taking prenatal vitamins. So what are some of the prenatal vitamins we consider? Like the client will be prescribed with the folic acids, iron supplements. These are usually recommended during the pregnancy. This is important, but compared to ACE inhibitors or compared to option 2, this is not that much a priority finding that require immediate intervention. I always said, whenever we are seeing a question in terms of priority or most concerned or serious, we should understand all the options might be correct. But out of all the options, one will be very serious or one will be more prior or more complicated than other three options. So that's why we choose option 2. Then option 3 was a whitish discharge, that is leucorrhea. That is usually an expected finding during the prenatal period. But if the woman is said that the amount is more and it is related with the signs and symptoms of foul smelling and redness or itching, that should need some intervention. But that is also not prior than option 2. Then option 4, that is the client have lower abdominal pain or cramping. That is also an expected finding, because the cramping may occur in the lower abdomen and inguinal region. That is an expected finding in the pregnancy. This common finding can be caused by stretching of the round ligaments and is usually not concerning in the absence of vaginal bleeding. If there is no bleeding, there is no problem, because the round ligaments that is stretching, that's why the mother, she is feeling cramping pain, because the baby is growing and the uterus will grow and the ligaments will stretch. So that is the pathophysiology behind this point. So I hope it's clear to you. If you have any doubt, like all videos I used to say, If you have any doubts, please mention. And bye for now. On the upcoming videos, we'll discuss some other topics.